Our lab historically has focused on developing tests for cancers of the blood. And then more recently, we've developed assays for solid tumors, so primarily for like lung cancer, GYN malignancies, ovarian cancers, prostate cancer, more common cancers. And so it's a streamlined, rapid assay that can detect clinically actionable gene mutations in the most common solid tumor types. So what we're trying to do is to identify therapeutic targets.
Eric and his team have developed the GatewaySeq test. The GatewaySeq test is a test that is designed to survey what we call the actionable mutations in solid tumors. It surveys a much more limited panel of genes, of DNA, a much more restricted part of DNA, in order to assess what we know are mutations that actually can define specific types of therapy, and some of the genes that may be indicated for future types of therapies that are under development. So the GatewaySeq is actually a test that can be run in the blood, but generally is run on tissue. That's a test that when a biopsy is taken or when there's surgery done for a specific cancer, once that diagnosis has been made, we can actually take the tissue that's been removed from the body and put into paraffin blocks where we've made the diagnosis, and take just a little bit of that tissue from that biopsy and assay it for these gene mutations. We've designed it for lung cancer, but there will be variations that will be developed within what I would call the GatewaySeq family for example, GYN tumors, women's cancers, for brain cancers. Those are the kinds of cancers that the GatewaySeq is designed to survey. Eric and his team can begin to modify the GatewaySeq, and they're already doing that for those other kinds of cancers.
And so they'll do a biopsy. It could be like an FNA, which is a tiny needle. It could be like a needle core biopsy, which is like a slightly bigger needle, but still you're talking about a piece of tissue that's like, you know, the size of a match or a match head sometimes. And so we can take that tissue, we look at it first under the microscope, and we determine, you know, is this a lung cancer or not? If we decide it's a lung cancer, then we'll send it for GatewaySeq testing. And so one of the advantages of the GatewaySeq panel is we can operate from very, very low DNA inputs. This is based on our experience with some of these other assays and our longstanding experience with sequencing. So even from a tiny, tiny piece of tissue, like the size of a pinhead, we can get enough DNA to sequence. The sequencing tells us if there are recurrent gene mutations. And those gene mutations, for a lot of solid tumor subtypes, will determine what therapy the patient gets.
GatewaySeq, in its first iteration, is actually approved by CMS. So that has gone through the kinds of testing and validation. It has already shown its clinical efficacy. It can change the management. It can define therapy for patients. So that test has already been approved for reimbursement.
We used our expertise to design the most efficient and inexpensive tests that we could come up with.
It allows clinicians to be much more specific about their therapy. And being more specific about therapy that works can literally save hundreds of thousands of dollars. So in that sense, it's a very cost-effective test.